Grab your breathing tubes and enjoy some nice charcoal water, because it's time to relax with the latest episode of Stop the Smoggies. Have you met the Smoggies? Actually, it's Io, and it's here to make us all feel super positive about the future of our planet. And though the future Io presents to us is one of utter devastation and death, the ending leaves us with a hint of hope. An ending which sees our protagonist, despite the toxic air, on a beach with a child and no oxygen mask. So how did we get here? Everything about Io revolves around Sam, played by Margaret Qualley from HBO's The Leftovers, and her attempt to cure the Earth of the poisonous toxin that's covered almost the entirety of its surface. And for all she knows, she's the only one left. Years earlier, the entire world peaced out to a colony orbiting Jupiter called Io, leaving her on a mountaintop observatory to... beekeep? Because if bees can survive, they can pollinate the world and give the Earth new life. Sam is also in contact with her boyfriend Elon on Io, who's trying to convince her to ditch Earth for the colony. And you thought your long-distance relationship was tough. And this is the real drive of the whole movie. Should Sam stay or go? It's a thread that keeps with us right until Io's last moments. At what point do we give up hope? Will she give up in the face of her parents' death? Will she give up when a swarm destroys the bee colony?
No, not the bees! Not the bees! Ah!
Will she give up when Elon says the next shuttle to Io will be the last? No, Sam continues forward, driven by a dream of the future where she stands, free of oxygen tank, on the shores of a beach. Her resolve is only shaken at the arrival of Micah in his hot air balloon. He's come to meet Sam's father, whose research is the basis from which Sam works to find a cure. In many ways, Micah is the anti-Sam. While she is driven by hope, he detests it. Hope is what kept him and his wife on Earth, the hope that Earth could be saved. We later learn it's why he came to see Sam's father, to kill him for giving them hope and dooming those that stayed. Side note, his name Micah is likely in reference to Micah the prophet, who preached of destruction and restoration. Sound familiar? He also prophesied, according to the Gospel of Matthew, of the Savior to be born in Bethlehem, also known as Jesus Christ. Another parallel, this time to the Savior born at the end of the movie. With Sam's bee research destroyed and a fancy new hot air balloon to take her to the shuttle, there's nothing left for her on Earth. She agrees to tag along with Micah and join the rest of humanity on Io. Even in the face of a queen bee surviving, Sam seems to have reached her limit.
So what does it mean?
It doesn't mean anything.
And here Io weaves another theme, one of the nature of human connection. Sam and Micah, having finally come back into human contact, naturally succumb to a romantic pull. When Micah attempts to back away,
I can't.
Sam says,
we have to.
But why? Why do they have to? Earlier, Micah talks about Plato's Symposium. That man once had two faces, four arms, and four legs, and then was split in two. Now we forever search to find our other half, to make one of two, reuniting our nature and healing the state of man. When Sam says they have to, it's because of what Micah told her about Symposium, aka connecting with another human is the cure. And so it will be for Earth too, as the connection these two make here literally births hope for the future of the planet. A child to survive the smog. This tie to Greek mythos and philosophy plays all throughout the movie, as Sam constantly references the Museum of Art, as well as a quote from a poem called Leda and the Swan, and it's no coincidence why. Leda is the mother of Helen of Troy, the face that launched 1,000 ships and began the Trojan War. When the Greek god Zeus came down in the form of a swan, he impregnated Leda with Helen. What Helen would bring to the world was war and destruction, the broken wall, the burning roof and tower, and Agamemnon dead. But this poem by Yeats is more important about something greater, the lasting impact of this war. It was the end of the ancient mythological era and beginning of modern history. One world died, and a new one was born. Just as it is in Io, the end of one world and the beginning of another. Micah, like Zeus, descended on Sam and impregnated her with a child that would change the face of Earth. We leave Io not with any assurances, but with a glimmer of hope, hope that something might change on Earth. The possibility that humanity can survive. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please like, subscribe, and make sure to check out all my other Ending Explained videos. I've got a lot more planned for the future, so be sure to stick around. And remember, Daddy loves you very much.